A wee heiny bach there lived a woman, and her man was a fisherman, and they lived in a vinegar bottle. And while they lived in his vinegar bottle, this woman, her name was Alice, but she was a naughty, domineering wife, and she always complained and complained every day about living in the vinegar bottle, and it was too crammed, and everything she could find fault with. But her husband only got a respite, and he would go to do his fishing again. And this day, he goes out fishing, and he catches the bonniest, beautiful calfish laddie. And when she gets this, he's got all this lustry colours on him and a very big bulk tusk to show that he was a meal Carlisle fish. And when he takes it, he says, my wife will be off a please, because this is just a beautiful prize fish that I've got. But he was even more surprised when the fish said to him, please, dinna kill me, because I'm not really a fish. I'm the old man of the sea. And as old man of the sea, I can grant you wishes untold. And he says, but my wife will be mad if I dinna take him a fish. He says, but just think of the wishes your wife could hear. So he spears a fish and he says, if ever you come to me, just call upon my name at this part of the river. So he goes home and tells his wife. Oh, and the wife's not half her age. She says, I never heard such rubbish. A big good fish in him to one left it. He says, but it'll grant you wishes. He says, well, we'll see if it can grant me wishes. He says, go back and summon the old man of the sea and tell him, I would like to live in a castle. I'm fed, sick and tired, biding in his vinegar bottle. So the man goes out to the river and he says, old man of the sea, come listen to me, for Alice, my wife, the plague of my life, has sent me to beg a boon of thee. He says, yes, and what is it your wife desires? He says, she wants to live in a castle. He says, well, go back, and where the vinegar bottle was, you'll find a huge castle. So when the man comes back, here's this huge castle, with creeper ivy going up besides, hundreds of grebe grooms, and his wife is in the middle here, and she's absolutely delighted. She says, this is wonderful, I've plenty of space. But the next morning, she was complaining and grumbling. She said, you know this, she said, at least my vinegar bottle was aye comfortable and warm and snug. This big draughty castle, so cold, and you feel winds coming in all directions, and so huge, she said, go back and tell the old man of the sea I would like a little country cottage. So the man goes back and says, old man of the sea, come listen to me, for Alice, my wife, the plague of my life, has sent me to beg a boon of thee. She says, what is your wife? Does she not like her castle? No, she said it's too big and draughty. She wants a bonny wee country cottage with a garden. She says, well, go back, and where the castle stood, you'll now have a bonny country cottage with a garden. So when he comes back, his wife's very, very happy. She says, oh, isn't this wonderful? A lovely little cottage with this beautiful garden. Just always what I wanted. But when she got up in the morning, she said, I've never seen so many funny wee beasties about this. She said, this garden's attracting all kind of bees and wasps and insects. And everywhere I look, there's wee beasties. And she said, I don't feel comfortable with all these wee beasties going about. Go back and tell the old man of the sea, I would like a caravan to live in. So the man goes back and says, old man of the sea, come listen to me, for Alice, my wife, the plague of my life, has sent me to beg a boon of thee. He says, what does your wife want now? She's near half a happy where we country cottage, because there's too many beasties going about. He says, but she would like to have a beautiful caravan. He says, go back, and where your country cottage stood, there'll be a caravan. So to go back, and she's very happy. She's in her wee caravan and everything, and it's a caravan that could move. And she says to her man, I'm very, very happy here. But the next morning she got up and she said, I'm accustomed to living in a house. I'm not accustomed to living in caravans. This is not the life for me. This is a gypsy life. There's no use for me. I'd never feel happy here. Go back and tell the old man of the sea, I want to live in a tenement, so I'll have plenty of neighbours. Old man of the sea, come listen to me, for Alice, my wife, the plague of my life, has sent me to beg a boon of thee. Says, what next does your irritating wife want? Is she never happy? Says, she would like to live in a tenement so she could have neighbours. Says, go back and where the caravan was, there'll be a tenement. She's back into a tenement and she's got all these neighbours in about the tenement. And she's fine and happy. She says, this is good having neighbours. But when she gets up in the morning, she says, I never thought there was so much noise come off of noisy neighbours, and they're always complaining and arguing. This is going to drive me insane. Go back and tell the old man of the sea, I would like to live in a house where I'll be happy and content. So he goes back and says, old man of the sea, come listen to me, for Alice, my wife, the plague of my life, has sent me to beg a boon of you. What next does she want? She would like to live in a house. So she's very, very happy and something that's comfortable. She says, go back, and where the tenement was, you'll find the house of her dreams. And so when a man went back, she was living back in her vinegar bottle. And so she divided in her vinegar bottle for the rest of her times. So that was the old woman in the vinegar bottle.